is about to begin here. We're going into the first one versus one. They're gonna play four total one versus one duels. The team that wins most of those takes 1 point. If both teams wins equal amount, that means two duels each, there's gonna be a fifth deciding duel. Head shooter or shotter. He's misspelled his nickname. There should be a second over there. Versus Devilo or D3 Bill Zero.
And also, if anybody's wondering which plane they are flying, this is the BF-109 F-4.
Which we have seen a few times now.
We have.
It's probably the second most picked plane next to the Yak... Was it Yak-1B? Yeah.
Also, guys, in 1v1, they have to cross over each other, just like you saw here, before they can start shooting each other. So now they are more than welcome to go shooting each other. No flap action.
Oh, really?
Just yet.
I was surprised nobody fired either, because they both crossed each other's crosshairs there.
I mean, being realistic, you would have thought they would have had a much better idea of
where their enemy is.
Yeah, so I have to agree that they could have even taken just a few pot shots. I mean, this plane does have quite a bit of ammo. I think it's about 200 rounds of 20mm cannons. So it's definitely... You know, you can definitely, you know, take a few sprays, especially in a 1v1. You definitely have enough cannon rounds to take somebody out. You know, at least five or six people out. So I feel like, yes, you are right. They could have easily have taken a few pot shots. Nice little bit of flap action.
All the flaps being used by Devil.
He just really needs to get just his nose
not
just up a little
bit more.
Not as much
flaps being used by Head Sugar.
Oh, those stealth rounds.
Oh, stealth. Stealth it is.
See, he's shooting.
But he's lost so much energy. Like you could see before, he just couldn't turn up. Like he just can't. Like Devilo, with the energy he has, is at the maximum altitude, which gives Hedger. Look at this. Like he's just coming in now.
And using those flaps. Oh wow! Stealth rounds from both guys.
Done. Shut down already. It was pilot kill, and he's just deciding to. Well, I'm not gonna let your plane look pretty. That was pilot snipe. Pilot kill. Like finished. There you go.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, using those flaps as well to stop an overshoot from even happening, it was just very nice. And a very nice, quick, clean kill. But again, it also didn't help the Devil was shooting as he was climbing. I mean, that would have obviously slowed him down even further, so it just made him quite a nice, easy target. Because he pretty much stalled out, so...
Let's take a quick look here on the airplane. It has two 15mm cannons, and it has one 20mm cannon, and it has two 7.92mm machine guns as well. Where it's 250 bullets in the two...
So yeah, it's got absolutely plenty of round to be able to... plenty of rounds.
250 into two 15mm and 200 into 20mm cannon and 1,000 machine gun rounds.
So there, again, there was absolutely no reason for them to start... For them not to spray each other in that second... that second head-on. So now moving into the second 1v1. With Rhinoceros being 1 point up.
Thank you.
So again, guys, they have to cross each other before they can start shooting each other.
Both decided to do a bit of a dive to gain some energy before going into the upwards climb. This is the most common maneuver in all of the one versus one we've been watching.
I mean, look at just how... I mean, the BF-109 isn't amazing in turn fighting, but look how quickly it was able to turn itself around because it had just... Because they had dived, they were able to gain up quite a nice lot of momentum and then just go straight into that half loop. Now we play the dance of death until one of them finds just a little bit of an advantage, probably in whichever one decides to use flaps first to be able to get into that turn tighter and faster.
Yeah, I mean, even in a Spitfire or any other plane which you could consider being a great turn fighter, people use the flaps to give even more so. And this plane, who doesn't turn very well, I mean, you kind of have to. Again, it's a mirror match as always. I mean, they're flying the same airplane, so if one guy uses flaps and the other don't, you turn better than him. Simple. Though you lose energy, which the other guy don't, which might be important depending on what maneuvers you want to pull.
I mean, they can't exactly... I mean, they, to an extent, they can fly away a little bit from each other, but they always need to be in a turn with each other. Mm. But absolutely having those flaps down and... to be turning, you're eventually going to catch up to him, even though you're going to lose a little bit of energy.
Maybe you want to do a hammerhead, like maybe that's what Johnny's doing right now. Look at this. No, well, almost. He's going upwards, losing a bit of energy, coming down.
But they're able to get that nose up.
Yep. Well, and Junior kind of did counter it, I would say, to climb like he did. Well, he was obviously also trying to get his nose on him, which none of them are still able to do. This is why these rounds can sometimes last so long, is because they're just do not get those crosshairs on each other.
I mean, it is a 1v1. I mean, they can't even call for a teammate who's probably, like, when we look at the 2v2s, we'll see that they might call each other to help each other out, even though they'll have somebody on their tail. I mean, we don't even have that, so there's no extra pressure, so they can just keep turning, and it'll be the person who kind of, that's a very close mountain. So there is nobody to add the extra pressure, so they can just keep turning.
Well, a few shots were fired, but they were not close. And now both are going into what would be a hammerhead almost. Oh, this! Oof! If he
Turner's
just
going to stall out.
That was close, yeah.
I'm slightly worried that this plane might not be able to pull up.
Yeah.
Nope. That's very close to the ground. Oh! Knew it! Pulled it. He was going just so slowly, and the BF-109 isn't great at pulling up. I unfortunately couldn't tell if he had flaps down. I'm going to go with he probably didn't have his flaps down. If he had his flaps down, he might have been able to pull up a little bit faster. But if he had already had his flaps down, he had no chance. Not any hope in hell.
And that is true.
And this is why you don't go slow towards the ground. Ground is very OP in this game. So White Rhinoceros taking a 2-0 lead in the 1v1s. All they need now is to win just one more 1v1, and they'll take the first point in this series.
And to respond to Blue Wolf, he's asking in Twitch why don't they let them use different airplanes? Well, the organizers is the Gladiators. The Gladiators tournament is actually a long-going organizer of tournaments in air combat flight sims. They've been arranging tournaments in everything, arranging all the way from the Microsoft Combat Flight Simulator through the Ill. Two Sturmovik games and many of the airplane combat games that is around there. They're organizing tournaments like this one, so they're not new to the format. And there is a little bit, I think, of what do you say? There's a little bit of a real life inspiration where they would, you know, train for combat, or they would do simulating scenarios and stuff like that. And while sure, you could have different airplanes, they've decided to go with having same airplanes for both, which would then make it more so down to the pilot skill. Then you can never ever look at the Gladiator tournament and go like, well, the reason he won was because he had the better airplane compared to me. Like, it can never happen. So again, that's why, you know, you have the same airplanes, just like you would in a sword fight have the same swords and stuff like that. I hope that answers your question. If you have any, like, if you do have feedback and you want to see other airplanes, I would suggest try and leave feedback on the War Thunder tournament forums, where the organizers of the tournament will read and respond to that. And in this game, we have Jimmy Jazz, cool nickname, going up against Maniac Sith Master. I hope he doesn't use the Force though, because that would obviously go like, well, then Jimmy would go like, well, sure, he had the same airplane, but he used the Force. Is that against the rules? I think so. I haven't read them all. Like, I don't think there's a rule saying do not use the Force, but I think it would go under, you know, do not cheat.
I gotta say, despite how close and how fast these guys sometimes fly towards each other in the first pass over, I have yet to see anybody ram each other in the first pass over. No flap action just yet, they don't... fully stealth
rams for
Jimmy.
The Sith Master is a 2 versus 2 duelist.
But Jimmy Jazz is a Gladiator 4v4 pilot.
Oh my god, how do you get that title?
I don't know.
That must be from being one of the very, very best in the Gladiator tournaments.
Maybe?
That is a cool title. Gladiators 4 versus 4. Wow. Me jelly.
Some rolling scissors going on. Some flaps to also stop him from overshooting. And to use the
there
flaps as a little
cooling,
extra lift.
There is coolant leaking from Jimmy. And that piece of the wing might be needed. He has technically been shot down anyway, but...
Oh, he parachuted out. I wanted to see his plane beforehand, but hey-ho. That was very nice. These are some very quick, clean games. I mean, yep. 303, unfortunately, haven't managed to get a kill, but they are still in the quarterfinals of the Super Cup.
Mm.
So, I mean, White Rhinoceros are most definitely very dominating at the moment. But, I mean, it could all change in the 2v2 and the 4v4. So I'm not gonna say 303 is out just yet.
There has never been a game where we've been able to say, well, these guys won the 1v1 duels, they're definitely taking the whole thing. Well, obviously when MBSI is playing, but otherwise, it has, what I'm saying is that, because now it sounded like I said that every team who wins the 1v1 loses, but that's not the case either. It's just that there's just no way to call it. Like, there's no way to call it. It's way too early. The 2v2 and the 4v4 is just so much more important point-wise that anything can still happen. The match is entirely open for anyone to take home. Yes, 303, according to chat, I haven't checked these facts yet, but according to Odyssey in Twitch chat, he's saying that 303 won the Gladiator Western tournament just a month ago, which might explain the cool title he had, I guess. Because it actually is, the Gladiator tournament itself is kind of called Gladiators 4 versus 4 or 4x4, meaning 4 versus 4. So that could be how he got the title, actually.
We would actually need to double check that fact.
The reason why they're in this tournament is because the top 8 best teams from the Gladiator tournament that happened at the end of last year are the ones participating in this one. This is a Super Cup. You couldn't sign up for this, guys. Like, this is the top 8 teams from the Gladiator tournaments that happened at the end of last year. They are the one who automatically qualified to this Super Cup. Oh yeah, I believe you, Odyssey.
So they won the Western version So we can't take away the fact that they're not, they haven't won a round yet, because they've essentially, in my opinion, already proven themselves. They won the Eastern side.
Oh, they've already proven themselves.
They're here now. So I don't think anybody could say, "Oh wow, you guys lost the quarterfinals at the Super Cup versus the other eight best teams. Oh no, you guys did so badly." No, hey. It's wow, you got to the quarterfinals. You guys did a great job. I hope you guys go all the way next time.
I don't know if we have any football fans watching, but I mean, if you get to quarterfinal in Champions League for football, it's pretty much the biggest tournament for football. It's like, oh, you know, quarterfinal? Damn, you're good. Like, it's just like that. I mean, the club, if you get there, it makes a lot of money.
All right.
So right now in the 2v2,
Biz Dummy, Domini.
We're just seeing two separate 1v1s as we start off the duel.
Mm-hmm.
In the 2v2, guys, they don't need to cross over each other, but it's very rare to see people go head-on with each other. They obviously don't want to give the advantage to the enemy pilot as well.
Here's bullets gonna go. Wow. And I will tell you that the Bez Domni has been set on fire, and there's nothing saving his plane. Even if it, yeah, he just jumped out, I think. Or he burned out.
And Turner just...
Alright, that was quick. We'll see what 303 can do in the next 2v2. Maybe that answers the next question from Blue Wolf, the question answer today. Asker, questionnaire, whatever. Blue Wolf, yet again, is asking whether there will be 2v2 or 4v4. Yes, we're right now spectating the 2v2. So here's how it actually works. First we had 1v1. The winning team got 1 point. We're now watching the 2v2 worth 2 points. There's gonna be one more here, and if White Rhinoceros wins that one, they earn 2 points. If 303 wins it, there's gonna be a third 2v2 to decide who gets the 2 points. After that, we go into a 4v4 match, which is worth 3 points. So there's a total of 6 points which one team can get, or as you heard, they could be split. There's 1 point, there's 2 points, and there's 3 points, all separately able to be taken by the teams.
About the fact that the reason why it looked like White Rhinoceros was team killing is because obviously we were spectating on their team, essentially. So they looked blue to us, and the enemy team looked red. Had we been looking at it from White Rhinoceros' opinion, it would have been red.
Yeah, it seems the referee role in the game right now as a spectator is... you're still considered on one of the teams.
I mean, we can still change team, but... it still just puts us on a random team.
I'm
not going to touch that one. We'll probably break it.
I will not touch it. SMJ is actually, I think, still they're still in this. They're also one of the top 8 teams, by the way. Worth mentioning. HTH, not sure which team that is. I don't know all the prefixes from the back of my head. But if they made it to, the quarterfinals of the Gladiator tournament that was played end of 2014, then they are in this tournament as well. Jimmy Jazz and Devilo is the duo to fight for 303. Maniac Sithmaster flies out with Phantom S for White Rhinoceros.
Is it me, or did Devil and Jimmy Jazz fly at like a 45 degree angle away from each other? Because they went pretty far out the map.
They're just like, bye!
I was almost expecting Jimmy Jazz just to ignore. Who's he flying against? Phantoms and just go and help his
and
teammate.
Wow. Devlo already shut out Maniac Sidmaster, which means it's now a 2v1, and he wanna hurry up and get over there to help his teammate get rid of Phantomus.
2 miles isn't that far, and as we saw in the 1v1s, they kind of just are circling each other. He's probably also going to try and bait him down a little bit to the ground, so his teammate doesn't need to climb so hard. Yeah, we can sort of see them as they're slowly getting lower and lower and lower.
And
here comes Devil.
Heard the bullets fire. Didn't seem to register anything.
So now Phantoms is just essentially just going to keep maneuvering, and every time he maneuvers, he's obviously going to lose energy, and he's going to become slower and slower and easier to hit. But this is unfortunately where the tide kind of turns.
Oh yeah, Devil is again on the going on for Phantom here. This should be an easy kill, and it just was. There you go.
Okay. You know, that was really unfortunate for Phantoms, because he actually shot Jimmy Jazz, and he actually shot his landing gear. His landing gear has gone straight off. So now we have ourselves a tie.
Yes, exactly. 303 took this round, guys, which means we're going to have a third deciding 2v2. I expect to see the same duo from 303 go out in this one, and probably White Rhinoceros want to send out the duo that won their 2v2. So if we're lucky, we'll see a fight between the two winning duos who will face off each other, and it will be like a mini final here of who is the best 2v2 team.
So you're thinking Jimmy Jazz, Devil versus Headshooter and Johnny K. That's your prediction on the...
That's my prediction.
I would agree with that. Don't fix what isn't broken.
If I were their coach, that's what I would do. If I were coaching both teams, that's what I would do.
These are very, very quick games. Like, these guys are just so good that they're just so confident in their planes that they can just get such easy, clean kills. They just know exactly where they need to point their noses so they can just get straight crits on the enemy. I mean, they haven't fired that many bursts. They've been really quick, clean bursts. Like, no more than 2 or 3 seconds, and they've just critted every time. Either a wing or a tail, and the plane has just gone straight down. It's just so nice to see just such clean kills. Rather than spraying and praying.
Bulv is asking, how do they decide which planes are used in a round? Before the match, actually, they have three groups of airplanes. Each group consists of three airplanes. Each team vetoes. They actually remove an entire group of airplanes each, leaving them with one group of airplanes left. That's three airplanes. Then each team again vetoes one airplane each, which again means they're removing an airplane, which leaves them with one airplane left, which both teams have to fly throughout the entire match. I gotta say that Maniac Sithmaster's camo is pretty cool, actually. I haven't seen that one on the BF-109 yet.
Again, Jimmy Jazz and Devil flew essentially, you know, 45 degrees
same,
away from each
it's
other.
It's the same duo. Phantomus and Maniac Sithmaster is getting a second chance here.
A rematch.
It's a rematch.
So again, two separate 1v1s. This is my personally least favorite tactic. Because you're not using your teammate. Like, the extra pressure he can add, even if he does one sort of strafing run, he could easily crit, especially with the sheer, like, amazing shots these guys have been doing this game. Could easily crit and take the guy out while he's trying to maneuver to dodge your other teammate.
Well, Phantomas and Jimmyjazz is already pretty low altitude, while Maniac Shooter and Devilo is still maintaining a very high altitude, and Maniac is just about to finish this guy. Yep, done. Called it.
I mean, look at how quick. Like,
well, I mean, Devil wasn't really doing much to not allow Maniac to do that, if
to be honest. So Devil was killed too. Jimmyjazz was also killed.
Meanwhile, I was, alright, well, okay.
I thought you were talking about Jimmy, because that burst was literally 2 seconds, and his plane, like he lined up his plane, just waited, counted to one, and just bursted him down.
Done. Alright, West. Wild Rhinoceros is taking home 2 points. This now means that 303 have to win the 4v4 to draw out the match and have a chance of winning the entire match. This is the winner bracket, though, so no matter how it goes, 303 still have a chance to make it through the loser bracket and get to the grand final. Nothing to be said yet, though, because, again, the 4v4 could change everything. If 303 wins it, then they will yet have a chance to take home the match. Since White Rhinoceros has 3 points, since the 4v4 is worth 3 points. Math. Simple. If you're wondering which matches are being streamed, guys, you can actually check that over on the Super Cup page. I'll link you guys that in chat. It's warthunder.com/en/special/supercup, with that special sound effect there, obviously. Let's see here.
I don't think we are. Would be the easiest answer.
Oh no, yeah. We're not, this is the only match being streamed and commentated on in English today. If you were wondering about a specific match, I meant more in general. You'll be able there to keep an eye on which matches will be streamed. You'll see a little camera thing with a link. If you click on it, you'll get to this page. Also make sure that you follow War Thunder here on Twitch, so that you don't miss any other game in the near future. We could. We also could take the moment here. We're waiting for them to get ready here. Rocket and Cytek are both sponsoring this tournament. There is an amazing, amazing ad video from Rocket showing off their new invention in what do you call it, in PC gaming mouse technology, which me and Adam has discussed before. We're curious. Have anybody tried out this new Rocket Mouse? We'll show you the video ad of it.
Meet the Rocket Tion, featuring the brand new Rocket Accelerator Analog Thumb Paddle, giving you unrivaled command capabilities. The new Rocket Fin Switch, letting you execute multiple maneuvers at the same time. 4 ergonomic top buttons, instinctively placed so that you can hunt for prey, not for buttons. Meet the new standard in gaming mouse control.
That advert is going to make me want to buy that mouse. I've now watched it like 10 times. I want to buy that mouse. That was like almost perfect timing. Advert finishes.
And the match.
Match
is
starts.
Ready to go.
It's like we planned it.
I'm actually gonna have to see if that mouse is available in little poor Sweden where I live. I haven't checked because I'm curious how much the mouse is actually. I mean, The one I'm using right now is on its last lifeline anyway, and I mean, if I have to replace it, I mean, why not? Like, I haven't had a Rocket product before. I've been curious for a long time. Why not satisfy that curiosity while getting that mouse and see how that fin is working, right? I mean, I feel like, you know, if you don't use the fin on it, it's probably still a pretty good mouse. Like, that's what I feel like, you know? Because I like the design. It looks to be fitting my type of hand, you know, big hands, stuff like that. So, I'm curious. I'm really, really curious about training, though. All right. Jimmy Jazz, Tuner 12, Devilo, Bezdomni is flying out for 303. They're facing off the White Rhinoceros, Head Shooter, Johnny K, Maniac, Sith Master, and Phantomas. And this is worth 3 points, guys. If White Rhinoceros come out winning here, they swing hard and take the entire match 6-0. If 303 takes home this round, they take 3 points, and it's going to be a 3-3 draw, and we'll have to play another round of something, which the teams will be deciding afterwards.
We have yet to have a game.
Phantomas
go to 3-3.
And Maniac is going on 2 here, and they're going 2 and 2 over here, too. Yeah, sorry, you were saying.
Yeah, 303 really like this whole split into twos, and
and whoa!
That was
okay.
Really great.
Johnny and Hedger almost collided as they took out the first 303 guy. Jimmy Jazz does now have a chance to take out Johnny, and he must not miss this chance. If he does, then... And he did miss that chance, and he will probably be taken out by Hedger, who's coming on his tail right now.
So, White Rhinoceros... Phantom
is
and
4 versus
Maniac.
2. Oh, 4 that's just one guy left. Actually, nope. Wow. Okay, wow. I have nothing to add to that.
That was very fast.
Guys, while this is amazing for a tournament, don't ever try and do this on a Saturday when it's Valentine's Day, because doing it this fast does not make the girls happy.
That joke was so bad.
I was like, I was trying to get something, dude. Like, you guys know what I mean, right? Don't buy chocolate. This is. We're done. Amazing. Great. Like, speed record set.
A final comment I would like to say is I do not want to meet White Rhinoceros in an RB game.
they seem pretty solid this time around.
That was very dominating. I think that's the only word for it.
There's no place for girls in the danger zone.
I mean, I'm now excited to see White Rhinoceros in the semis and the finals. I'm excited to see if they can continue up that sheer aggression and domination. I mean, they went up against 308 Poland. That was their match before, and they went 0-6 versus them. And now they've gone 0-6 versus 303. If
they're gonna face SoWar, who 6-0'd STB, they 4-2 against Aces. White Rhinoceros, before this they played 306, who they also 6-0'd. So White Rhinoceros looking good, might be favorites going into the semifinal versus SoWar. Because they have not lost a single round so far.
Nope, the momentum is most definitely on their side.
Definitely.
If I was them, I would go into this next game feeling like absolute champs.
Meanwhile, their Adler, who's facing Sky Veterans in the other semifinal, they have 4-3. They actually had to play a deciding round in the round of 8 versus Squads United. In the quarterfinal, they faced off versus Wild Spirit, where they went 4-2. They're facing Sky Veterans, who in the round of 8, 6-0'd Onyx from Greece. They 5-1 versus SNJ. And they're facing off in the other semifinal. So even there, I guess in that other semifinal, you would look at the stats and go like, well, Sky Veterans
looking solid. Der Adler, been, you know, just, you know, they've been just beating the opposition. So there's two really interesting semifinals coming up. I'm going to see when exactly that is. I think we have both happening tomorrow. Both is happening tomorrow. We are going to be spectating and watching Sowor versus White Rhinoceros. I'm saying we, but it's going to be you, Adam, going to be soloing that. I won't be around at the time. After that, we will be watching Royal Air Force versus 306 in simulator battle round one. I think it's the loser bracket. That one.
I think
it's just
so
as round one, because I think in loser bracket they have round one, round two, round three, just to separate them. That's gotta be interesting as well. And I think that's it. Do you have anything to add?
I'm scared of White Rhinoceros.
You're scared of White Rhinoceros?
That is a beast I do not want to see.
On the opposing team.
On the opposing team.
Alright. Well, again, thank you all for watching. Guys, make sure that you follow War Thunder here on Twitch so you don't miss any future coverage of this Super Cup or any other live-streamed content. The commentary has been brought to you by me, Scream112, and Average Adam, both at other times being live and streaming over on twitch.tv/metagamingtv. Feel free to go over there and follow us there as well. It's been a pleasure. Thank you, Rocket and SciTech, for sponsoring the tournament. And we'll see you guys again tomorrow for more of the Super Cup. Good night.